It was a really good experience, and I feel like it helped me, like, actually pay attention more, because I feel like when I'm reading sometimes, it's like every 2 minutes I'm thinking about something else and I'm getting distracted, and then I have to go read the whole page again. But yeah, I feel like it really helped, and it was so relaxing and refreshing to just finally read again, because I have not in so long. But yeah, I really enjoyed that, and I will probably be reading more of this before I go to bed tonight, which I'm really excited about, because it's like I'm excited to read the book. Excuse me. But basically, so sorry for my rambling. So this is about Franny, and Hayes is the male main character's name, and this is everything I've read is like pretty much what's on the back of the book. She like gets laid off from her job, and then her dress rips on the subway, and then this guy like gives her like his suit jacket, and then like someone posts it on Instagram, and they're like going viral, and this says Franny and Hayes couldn't be a more disastrous match. She's bright, talkative, and creative. He's serious, shy, and all about numbers. Luckily, in a city of 8 million people, they never have to meet again. Only somehow, Hayes and Franny keep running into each other, and much to their surprise, they enjoy each other's company a lot. But when Franny's whole world is turned upside down again, can she find the courage to trust herself and finally have the life and love she's always wanted? If that doesn't sound so interesting to you, I don't know what is. But yeah, I don't know. And I thought the cover, like, it really drew me in when it was on the table. And I don't think I've heard too much about this book, but I was really intrigued by the cover and reading the back of it. And just by reading the first chapter, I feel like I'm gonna really like it. It's something about books that are set in New York, and it's reminding me of like, Friends. I love Friends. I just started rewatching it actually, because I watched it for the first time. It was last year, but it was like this time of year, so I've restarted it. I watch it on the treadmill when I'm at the gym, and I just put it on here and there, and I love it so much. It's like my number one comfort show, and it kind of like, you know, based in New York, it reminds me of that. So yeah, just started reading this, really enjoying it, and really enjoying listening to it on audiobook as well, so that might be something that I continue to do more frequently. We'll just kind of have to see. But anyways, this is the first book that I will be reading this month. Already started it, and I'm hoping to finish it in a couple days, because I need to get going if I want to read all these in the second half of the month. But that was in a New York minute. Okay, next. I wanted to read this at Halloween time, because, you know, it's a thriller, but I feel like it's still fall. There's still the like creepy, spooky vibes in the air a little bit, you know. But this is The Locked Door by Freda McFadden, and this is the book that I've most recently purchased. Of course, the clock is gonna ring now, but, so I kind of, I think it was the In Me. I've heard people really did not like that one, so, I did not pick that one up. I picked this one up instead. I was going, actually, to look for The Boyfriend, which just came out, and everyone's, like, reading that, but when I went to Walmart, they did not have that one, so I picked up this one instead, and it just sounded really interesting. So it's like her father was like a serial killer and she didn't know, and then he's in prison and she's a successful surgeon with a quiet, solitary existence, and nobody knows about her past and she'll do anything to keep it that way. But then one of her female patients is murdered with the same way that her father used to people, if you know what I'm saying. I don't want to say that too much, but and someone basically wants her to be framed. Yes, framed. But yeah, I don't know. It seems kind of intriguing and kind of like, I feel like this one is really gonna make me think. Like the other one, it made you think, but I feel like it wasn't too complicated. This one, just, you can tell based by me trying to read the back and explain it to you that my brain, yeah, my brain is working. But her books, I really like that they have short chapters, and I feel like that will help me get through it quicker. And that's the one thing about In a New York Minute, that first chapter was 30 pages. That's a little long for me. So the fact that I could have the audiobook going and I just sped it up a little bit, it really helped. But I feel like this is one that I will be able to actually read without the audiobook because the chapters are shorter and, yeah, really fast-paced, really. A lot of these books, I just picked them for this month so that I can get back into reading because they're really fast-paced and shorter, and I feel like I'll be able to really get into them, if that makes sense. So that's The Locked Door. The only problem with her, like, more like thriller books, not her specifically, but just like thrillers, I've only read a couple, but it's because I usually will read before bed and I get spooked out, and then I don't get sleep because I'm scared. Anyways, so this might be the last one that we read because I really do want to get through everything else. But let me know any of these books, if you guys have read them, what do you think about them? So there is The Locked Door. And then next, this is probably the one that I'm designer, but so she basically gets there and she finds herself in a dive bar where she can't seem to shake the eyes of a handsome cowboy. When she leads him to the back of the bar, he leaves her with a kiss that most people could only fantasize about. She almost regrets that she'll never see him again, except it turns out he's her new boss. Genre. is like the